Did you see the red moving worm-like attached to this terrapin? Is it a worm? If not, what do you think it is? This is a Be Kind to Pets veterinary educational video sponsored by Topayo Vets. This video shows disturbing contents. Viewer discretion is advised. Bloodworms in red ear slider. On this video, we will learn what are these parasites, how did the terrapin get it, and the management and the treatment. If you find this topic interesting, just keep on watching till the end of this video. This 28 years old female red ear slider came in very lethargic, weak, and not eating for 2 weeks. During examination, you can also notice the swelling on the neck and legs. Upon opening the mouth, it was noticeable that the tongue is very pale, and it's an indication that this terrapin has severe anemia. The owner said that this terrapin stopped eating pellets and has been on vegetable diet for the past 20 years. The main complaint was the bloodworms found by the owner inside the terrapin's tank. The owner called the vet prior to the consultation as she did an internet research which showed bloodworms being common in turtles. They also asked if this slider, who was fed vegetables only for past 20 years, could be infested with bloodworms. What are these so-called bloodworms? These worms seen in this terrapin are likely fly larvae. The newly hatched larvae has blood inside their transparent bodies and hence are mistaken for bloodworms. These fly larvae spend most of their developmental cycle in the water and it takes about 3 weeks to become an adult fly from egg. So if the water in the terrapin's tank haven't changed for quite long, this will become a good breeding site and you will probably see these fly larvae floating into the water and can only stick into the different parts of the body. You can also notice the greenish coloration on the skin, which is an algae. Algae tends to grow well in tanks because of the amount of waste terrapins produce, which acts as nutrients for the algae. An overgrowth of algae may indicate other issues that could potentially harmful for terrapins. These algae growing on the skin and shell of this terrapin would be the food source for the fly larvae. That's why this fly larvae sticks to the skin. The slider also had swollen neck folds and skin folds between the hind legs. These are signs of edema relating to retention of fluid under the skin. Edema can be caused by liver problems, cardiac problems, or kidney problems, and there can be other causes as well, including infectious, parasitic, nutritional, fungal, viral, mycoplasma, and more. What causes terrapin to get sick? Terrapin health is largely related to its surrounding and the feed. For this case, both of these factors affect this terrapin, as it mainly lives in the tank that is probably didn't change water regularly. This terrapin may suffer from various infections caused by the foul water. Their immune system will go down and they are more susceptible to any diseases. The most severe of it is the sore of the oral cavity, which can lead them to stop eating. If they will not eat for a long period of time, this will lead to anemia. What are the treatments? This very lethargic terrapin needs close monitoring, antibiotics and anti-inflammatory to treat infection, diuretics to reduce the fluid retention in the body, and syringe feeding to bring back the nutrients that was lost. Conclusion: red ear slider is the most commonly kept turtle in captivity. Their health mostly depends on the environment and feeding. They are cold-blooded creatures that are sensitive to temperature changes, so it's important to keep them in their habitat. Changing the water regularly will prevent the overgrowth of the algae, breeding grounds of any parasites, and weaken their immune system. If the behavior change and they never eat, quickly seek advice to the veterinarian to prevent further infections. For more information, please visit topayovets.com. Thank you for watching.